Welcome to Beyond the News, I'm Faye. Cases of the COVID-19 Delta variant have spread all over the world. WHO has called the Delta variant the most contagious COVID variant that we have seen so far. It can be transmitted without physical close contact. Today, we'll look at three aspects. Firstly, COVID-19 has been around for 1.5 years, and surprisingly, its symptoms of detection have changed over time. Symptoms are no longer the loss of taste and smell. So what are the typical symptoms now? Secondly, we'll compare the effectiveness of the major vaccines available for the Delta variant. Finally, let's take a look at the newly discovered side effects of the vaccines and who needs special attention. Let's start from the changing symptoms first. Recently, Harvard Medical School, London King's College Hospital, along with two other world-renowned medical institutions working with the tech company Zoe, published a report which is part of the COVID Symptoms Study. This is a study focusing on COVID patients' symptoms. More than 4.6 million people have joined the program. The participants use an app to report their symptoms on a daily basis, while the data will be studied and analyzed. The study found an interesting trend. If we track back to the start of the pandemic, what are some of the top COVID symptoms on top of head? Most people would probably say fever, cough, loss of smell and taste, and shortness of breath, especially loss of smell and taste. This is typical. However, the study found that symptoms have changed drastically. The top 5 COVID symptoms are now headache, sore throat, runny nose, fever, and coughing. Did you guys notice these symptoms are pretty similar to flu or common cold? It's like a carbon copy of each other. The once knowing symptoms, losing smell and taste, had dropped to number 9 on the list. Shortness of breath is at number 30, no longer a main symptom. Another interesting they found, if you are vaccinated and you have COVID, one of the most reported symptoms is sneezing. So experts have suggested, if it feels like you have a bad cold or you are vaccinated but you sneeze uncontrollably with no initiator, you should be alerted and get tested as quickly as possible. As for the reason why the drastic change in COVID symptoms, the new Delta variant likely played a major role. Professor Tim Spector from COVID Symptom Study said, the trend of symptoms shift in England has started in May, and currently, the Delta variant accounts for 96% of all COVID cases in Britain. Thus, there are signs of correlation between the two. In summary, the symptoms of COVID are more like a bad cold, and the typical symptoms of COVID at the start of the pandemic, the loss of smell and taste, shortness of breath, and even fever has become less and less common. Thus, without these obvious symptoms, people should be wary and stay alert on the symptoms of COVID. Here we come to the second aspect, which is how the vaccines defend against the Delta variant. According to the latest information from the US Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC for short, the variants may have the ability of immune evasion, in which, even after getting the shot, the virus is able to escape being killed by the antibodies our body has produced. Thus, the neutralizing ability from antibodies stimulated by the vaccine is ineffective against the virus. Let's now take a look at the mainstream vaccines' capabilities. We'll look at Pfizer and AstraZeneca first. According to the data released by Lancet, Pfizer's strength is better than AstraZeneca, but both of them require a second shot to develop a barrier against the virus. 2 weeks after the second shot, Pfizer has an efficiency of 79% against the Delta variant, while AstraZeneca has an efficiency of 60%. Within 4 weeks of the first shot, the Pfizer only has 36% efficiency and the AstraZeneca only has 30%. However, in terms of protecting patients going to hospital, AstraZeneca and Pfizer both performed well, with Pfizer having a slight edge. One shot of Pfizer was 94% effective and 96% after 2 shots. AstraZeneca also has an effective rate of 71% and 92% respectively. Now let's look at Moderna and Johnson & Johnson next. Moderna has released a report a few days ago claiming their vaccine is effective against a series of new COVID variants, including the Delta variant. But Moderna did not provide a substantial explanation on how effective their vaccine is. When you look at their experimental research, there were only 8 people who participated, and only one of them was infected with the Delta variant. This raised the question on how accurate the data from Moderna is. Similar situation with Johnson & Johnson. They claim their vaccine is effective against Delta variant, but their experiment only consists of 6 participants. In addition to those 4 major vaccines, Novavax has also developed a new vaccine that uses a brand new technology called recombinant protein technology. It is different to mRNA vaccine from Pfizer or Moderna, as well as Johnson & Johnson and AstraZeneca's adenovirus vector vaccine. The mechanism of this vaccine is for the human immune system to respond to the protein in the vaccine. Compared with other vaccines, the human body will kick in a faster immune response. So, what is the perspective of the Novavax vaccine? According to their phase 3 clinical data, Novavax is 90% effective against the original COVID virus and has 100% critical illness protection rate. In addition, they are also 93% effective against the major COVID variants in the world, including Delta. However, if you dig into the number, the way they obtaining the 93% effective rate is by collecting all the variants together. There are only 9 volunteers infected with COVID variants, and only 2 of them are infected with the Delta variant. So no conclusion can be drawn on the effectiveness of the Novavax vaccine against Delta. Moreover, Novavax has not yet been approved by the CDC, so it should still take some time before it becomes available. In summary, Moderna, Johnson & Johnson, and Novavax don't have the hard evidence to show their effectiveness. Pfizer and AstraZeneca have the data to show how effective they are against the Delta variant. However, when choosing Pfizer or AstraZeneca, we should not only consider the effectiveness of the vaccine, but also their side effects. For AstraZeneca, many young and middle-aged women experience thrombosis after getting the vaccine. So most countries have recommended AstraZeneca to their elderly population. Not only AstraZeneca, Pfizer also have their own side effect. In a recent study, it was found that after receiving 2 doses of mRNA vaccines, Pfizer or Moderna, male soldiers in the US military had more cases of myocarditis than expected. The CDC report also confirmed that Pfizer and Moderna vaccines may cause heart inflammation. The side effect mainly occurs in young males between the age of 12 to 24. The symptoms often occur within a short time of vaccination, and the second shot has a higher chance of triggering the side effects. So from this point of view, AstraZeneca and Pfizer are not very user-friendly to young people and even a bit of sexist. So relatively speaking, AstraZeneca has a slightly lower risk to males and Pfizer has a lower risk to females. Overall, the information about the effectiveness of the vaccines and their side effects are limited now. It is also worth noting that although Pfizer and AstraZeneca vaccines are effective against Delta, but the protection is not permanent, and the antibodies produced by the vaccine will decrease over time. Therefore, even those who have received 2 injections should not think they're off the hook, because they are still at risk of contracting the virus. Take the recent resurgence in Israel as an example. Their health department did an investigation into the infected people. They found that 90% of the patients were infected with the Delta variant, and more than half of the infected had already received 2 doses of Pfizer vaccine. How did this happen? There are 2 possibilities here. First, Israel started vaccinating in December last year, and over time, the number of antibodies produced by the Pfizer vaccine has declined over time. Secondly, the Delta variant has immune evasion, resulting in a decrease in the neutralizing ability of antibodies, which result in vaccinated people being infected. So even if you get the vaccine, you can't take it lightly. All right, we talk about the Delta variant and vaccines today. Suggestions we have drawn are references only. Hope you find it helpful. If you do, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching Beyond the News. I'm Faye. No matter what happens, stay safe and stay free. Until next time.